What's up, what's good? So we are back with an edit with me session, and I really enjoy doing this because everything's live and I can explain every move that I'm gonna do with this one. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy this. So anyway, before I start, I want to give a very big shout out to Charlene Rotanen for being the model of this shoot. I really enjoyed shooting with her because, you know, she was really good with the posing and everything, and I really enjoyed, you know, directing her and shooting her. So thank you so much, Charlene. Make sure to check out her channel. The link is in the description box, okay? So, and also in the cards if you want to check her out, okay? So now let's get on with the basics. So the usual, the exposure, when you increase it, sometimes I can see how much I can make the photo bright and how much I can just fade it all out with the contrast. When I meant by fade, this fade, not the fade that I usually do with the Hypebeast or like streetwear photos that I do. So for the contrast, I just do around for 16 first. No, I mean, I don't stop there. I just have to gauge it from that point. Highlights, not too much, because it will just wipe out or wash out all those lights in the background or every setup that you have when you're shooting outdoors. And then when you lower the shadows, you can see you can crush all those parts of the hair. It doesn't really help sometimes when you're shooting already at dark photos, but let's experiment with this one, okay? So increase this white part right here, or probably just lower the contrast. You can see you can have like a halfway point for how dark and bright it is, okay? And increase the blacks. You can see it will just reveal the face more, but I would love to have some shadows in the face. So let's just add just a bit. Clarity, this will make your photo sharp. So please, guys, don't put too much, because it will just make it too HDR. I mean, for me though, if that's your style, I respect that. But if you just want to add some sharpness into your photos, it's either you put this one or the sharpness in the box. The lower part of this section right here for editing. Vibrance, not much. I think I'm fine with this already. It's either this or just increase, so you can see how much the skin tone will be saturated. For the tone curve, this is the point where I can decide where I'll make the photo faded. So I have 4 points right here. I'll explain it to you. So this point right here, when you increase it, it will make it fade, or like it will look like the usual editorial fades for your prints. For your photos. And then for this one, for this one, this will be the basis of it. But yeah, I have it right here, just in this box right here at the lower left, so I can have an anchor for this one. And for this one, this will like tweak the highlights of your photos at this point. And this is the midpoint, or like this is the, I don't know, the brightness of the whole photo. So this is like my 4 base points, and then I increase this one just to have more control for the highlights in the background, just a bit, you know. I just increase it just a bit, because I don't want to wash out the colors or of the lights, or probably how bright it is. For the HSL, the hue, saturation, and luminance, for this one, the usual ones that I do before, as you can see, for those who are asking, yes, you can somehow play with the blues with this one, and oh my god, it's teal. But yeah, sometimes I just want to omit or like shy away from using teal already. Anyway, so let's just close this one so you can see better, okay? So when I do this one, I lower or just kill the blue colors most of the times, like 75, and just increase the luminance to make it brighter. I want those denim to be emphasized better rather than just killing it off. So here I just made it just slightly bluer, okay? Saturation, just a bit, like 10 or probably 15, so the skin tone will be popped out. The red, this will affect the umbrellas in the background and the lipstick, as you can see, so just put it right here, okay? Also, while I'm doing this, let me explain to you some tips and share to you how I go around with HSL. So when I look at the photo, I always look at, you know, what colors will be affected, or for you to, like, if you don't have like that sense yet for like, oh, I think this will be blue, I think this will be yellow, you can use these buttons to see how much you can check those parts out. Like for this one, you want to check how much you can desaturate the skin tone. So put it here and just drag down. You can see how much it will affect it, right? So, but if you're like already used to it, you want to like go around and just go by this HSL part, you can go in each button and just lower it. And you know, skin tones most of the times is red, orange, yellow, or probably sometimes purple and magenta when you're shooting at neon light. So yeah, it depends on how you want to approach it. So there you go, just brighten those up. Again, U is for how, you know, the shade of the color, and the saturation of what to pop or kill those colors, and luminance, how dark or bright you want those colors to be, okay? I mean, when it's affected by it, by the way. Also for the split toning, just a quick tip though, if you want some vintage look into it, I just, you know, played around with this one. Put some green right here, it's around this part, it's around 110 or something, and add some saturation in it, and you can see it's green already, right? It's like those Tokyo Japan photos that, or Japan photos that you can see with the neon lights, but you know, my photo's not too neon, so anyway, I add some green highlights into it, and then add some red shadows, okay? So it's halfway vintage, halfway not. And you can see, set out the balance right here for the highlights just a bit. So play around with it, you know, how much you want to put in it. But for this one, I'll add just a bit, because Charlene is really Asian like me, so I really love her look on this one, so I'll probably put some into it. Anyway, for the detail, sharpening, most of the time I put zero into it, but right now I want to add some grain into it or something, or like sharpness, so probably around 50. And then you can see it will just sharpen those parts a bit. And then for masking, just put some 50 or probably 70. So I like to go halfway around it. There you go. For noise reduction, I add sometimes around 20 to 15, but that will just make your photo too soft if you increase too much. You can see that later. Sometimes it doesn't load that much. See, it looks too cartoony. So please, 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 please avoid that. So just let's stick with 20 or 15. And lastly, if you want some grain into it, you could just click this one, all right? Probably just 15 or 20. There's some vintage look into it. And also for calibration, most of the time, I just don't go directly to HSL, I'll go to calibration. There's some versions to it, but most of the time, I just noticed that I'm using version 4, the current one. So yeah, depends on you. So this is RGB, right? So play around with it. When I lower this one, it will not just affect the blue, guys, it will affect the blue portions of the whole picture. So when you desaturate it, it will affect also the skin tone, because those skin tone parts will have blue in it as well, because you know, when you mix RGB, you make the whole color. So yeah, just to explain that part, it's really nerdy. So anyway, I play around with this one. This sometimes I go to red because I want the skin tone to pop out, and the green ones, this makes it like too saturated, but not too much for this one, because I don't want it to be too orange. Anyway, and lastly, my favorite part, the treatment of the eyes. I love putting my model's eyes into this, to the highlight, because I want it to be the focus, because you know, the windows to the soul is the eye, blah blah blah. I love saying that, because you know, and also when I take photos, this is my like everyone else is the usual focus. Let's just edit this one right here. Okay, so just clean it up if you want, but sometimes I love putting those messy parts right at the edge to make it softer. Oh, sorry, my bad. There you go. So when you select that, you can desaturate it. As you can see, you can desaturate those parts, and just let's press O if you want those markers out. And just increase the exposure to pop it all out. Okay, there you go. And I'll add a new one. This is my usual one. I love putting the highlights or details of the eyes, because sometimes I really love, I'm fortunate that all my models look has really great eyes. So I love putting it into the focus. So add some contrast and some highlights into it, so it will be highlighted better, and some clarity, lower the clarity so it will be softer. Shadows, just to like make it look more seamless or something like that. And there you have it. So pretty much I enjoyed doing this shot and you know, editing it as well, because it challenged me to put the skin tones out, even if I was using the Eterna color or like picture profile of Fujifilm, because it makes the photo flat, but makes it better for me to like edit the colors out and color grade it properly. So yeah, so make sure to check out that one if you're using Fuji. But if you're using others, I think most of the mirrorless right nowadays has some flat settings, I'm not sure, but yeah, you can just play around and just you have more control with the colors. I believe. So there you go. So let's just have a quick comparison for the before and after. Ta-da! So you can see I have some green ones right here because of the highlights. The skin tone is now better. It's more popped out and highlighted. The eyes are more emphasized, but I didn't like highlight the full set of the eyes. I mean, even the ones covered in glasses or under the glasses, because that will make it look too weird. So yeah, just keep it real. Okay guys, if you want to have a copy of the whole settings or the preset that I used here, make sure to check out the link in the description and check out the links that I have for you guys. They're great communities. Make sure to check them out, all right? And also, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Peace.